A Russian court has labeled Facebook's parent company, Meta, an extremist organization. This report tells us why.
Facebook owner Meta was labelled an extremist organisation by a Moscow court Monday that upheld a lawsuit filed by Russian state prosecutors on banning the activities of Meta on Russian territory. But it said the decision would not apply to its WhatsApp messenger service, instead focusing on Instagram and Facebook, which are already banned. The court said the decision didn't apply to WhatsApp, quote, due to its lack of functionality for the public dissemination of information. But it may be falling out of favour with Russians. Analysis of mobile internet traffic on Monday showed that Telegram has overtaken WhatsApp to become the country's most popular messaging tool in recent weeks. Meta did not immediately respond to a request for comment, but the company's lawyer had said in court earlier on Monday that the firm was not carrying out extremist activities and stood against Russophobia. That's according to Interfax News Agency. Russia banned Facebook for restricting access to Russian media while Instagram was blocked after Meta said it would allow social media users in Ukraine to post messages urging violence against Vladimir Putin and troops Moscow sent into Ukraine last month. Meta has since narrowed its guidance to prohibit calls for the death of a head of state and said its guidance should never be interpreted as condoning violence against Russians in general. The implications of labelling Meta an extremist organisation remain unclear.
Ukraine accuses Russian troops of using stun grenades and gunfire to disperse a rally of pro-Ukrainian protesters in the occupied city of Kherson. At least one person was reported wounded. Russia has yet to comment on the incident, but it has repeatedly denied targeting civilians. Kherson was the first big urban centre to fall into the hands of Russian troops. Earlier this month, Ukrainian authorities claimed Russian forces detained more than 400 people in the region who were protesting against the occupation.
Here at home, President Rodrigo Duterte says the Philippines may be caught in the crossfire if the Russia-Ukraine war escalates. He claims China could also invade the Philippines during the chaos.
The name of the game is pressure. It will end only if Putin wants it, or is taken out. And if, by unfortunate chance, perchance, talagang maipit si Putin at tusukin niya yung pula na botones, wala na. Then, my thinking is, pag mag-ganon yan, China will invade. Pero sa intelligence briefing, tatamaan talaga tayo.
In the same speech, Duterte also reiterated his friendship with Russian President Vladimir Putin, but said there's one thing that makes him different from the Kremlin leader.
Kaibigan ko si Putin, pero sunobra. Ang pinapatay ko, kriminal. Si Putin binubomba pati babae, bata, lahat na. O sino man pinatay ko dito na para man sa inyo yan, para sa inyong mga anak, hindi man para sa... What do I get?
President Duterte also saying he will not support global calls to rally behind Ukraine to the delight of Russia's ambassador to the Philippines. Marat Pavlov says Duterte's neutral stance on the matter can pave the way for more cooperation between the two countries, particularly in the oil and nuclear energy front. Duterte's choice to stay neutral was contrary to Manila's signing of a United Nations resolution condemning Russia's attacks.
Russia is ready to satisfy the Philippine side's demand for fuel and food supplies. Russian companies are interested in developing cooperation with the Philippine partners in the field of energy, oil and gas exploration, construction of new power plants, and modernizing aging power plants in the Philippines. I can say that the very promising area of the cooperation is nuclear energy for peaceful purpose.
The envoy's remarks come as Western countries ban Russian oil imports as part of a growing list of sanctions against Moscow's assault on Kyiv.